Good evening, and welcome to Eastview High School and our wonderful Performing Arts Center. My name is Frank Pascarella. I am one of the co-directors of Varsity Band, who you see seated on stage. We are very, very happy to have you with us tonight for the debut performance for our freshman band students. There are approximately 40 other ninth graders who are not here with us tonight. They were members of the marching band, and they will have their debut performance on stage in January. We are so thrilled to have you here on this Thursday evening. We have four tunes for you this evening. We're going to kick things off with an upbeat concert opener entitled First We Dream by Eric Morales.
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Rich Bergen. I'm with Mr. Pascarella. I'm the co-director of our school band. It's been a wonderful opportunity to get to meet these students, and we've got the rest of the year to continue to develop as musicians. We're off to a really wonderful start. After tonight's concert, for the rest of the quarter, we'll be focusing on auditions for next quarter's concert bands, and it's a really good time for learning. We've got a challenging audition that the students can be working on, so hopefully you'll hear some practicing at home over the next couple of weeks. We also will be beginning our jazz band season at the beginning of second quarter, around November 8th and 9th. We're doing a jazz band auditions. That's a great time for students to choose to be involved in a different co-curricular activities, and that's a really great one. So if your student's interested in jazz, look for that audition as well. And we've got a lot of opportunities coming up for the rest of the year. We'll tell you more about them as we get closer to them. Our second piece tonight is entitled Yorkshire Ballad by James Barnes.
Thank you.
practice a little bit of time for a percussionist to do some fairly radical changes with instruments in the back. What you've seen so far is a very it's a very standard, traditional look at what we do day to day. We are preparing and we are performing very traditional concert band works. It's what concert bands do. It's not the only thing that our students are eligible to do at BCU. We will start jazz bands here fairly soon. We've just completed a season with our very successful marching band, and we are about ready to begin our winter sports seasons, believe it or not. And with that comes the opportunity for these students to participate in pep bands. And pep band is a voluntary opportunity for all of our band students to attend some of our home games for our hockey programs, for our basketball programs, our wrestling program, and our CI Adaptive 4 hockey programs. We have started preparing students for the opportunities by, first of all, showing schedules, and our last piece on our concert, Danger Zone, from that glorious movie from the 1980s, Top Gun, it's sort of an example of what kind of music we play for our pep bands. They're more pop or rock charts. We sort of serve as some entertainment to get the crowd going and to add some atmosphere to some of our athletic games. We schedule 8 regular season games, and then if we have teams that move into the section finals or into the state champion the tournaments, then a pep band will follow. Last year, we have a very successful girls basketball team, and we had both boys and girls hockey make it to section finals. So we follow those teams, as far as their seasons go. So this is an example of a volunteer opportunity that kids will have during winter. This is Danger Zone, and you can see that our percussion have wheeled out a bunch of different instruments tonight. These are instruments that you would see very commonly with our marching band, and of course with our pep band, you'll hear the rafters shake when we start doing these types of tunes in the gymnasium. So we're going to conclude our varsity band concert this evening with Danger Zone. Thank you. onstage is the concert band. And as you can tell, in comparison to our first performing group this evening, this group is quite small. And there are opportunities for amazing growth in small bands. The students that are on stage are grades 10 through 12, and these are students that will be in concert band for the remainder of the year. So you kind of get a feel. So throughout the rest of the school year, when you see performances, you'll recognize these kids. There are probably double the size of these kids who are in marching band. So they're not with us tonight, but they'll be there starting second quarter. The growth opportunity in this band is that because there are so few students in the band, that every student is so accountable for their individual part. And the students will share maybe with you that at first, that's a little scary. And first couple weeks of this quarter with this band, you know, it was kind of a, okay, now I actually have to play my part, because there are many parts that you'll hear tonight. It's just a single person. And that's great for kids sometimes to be put on that spot where they are they are their section. And so at least for me, I've had a tremendous time with these kids. It's maybe one of my favorite music making experiences in an awful long time with these kids. The way that they play, I'm very, very proud of the work that they've done. So we have a quartet of works. We're going to start with a very, very traditional work for wind band. It's called Flourish for Wind Band by one of Great Britain's greatest composers, Ralph Vaughan Williams. Selection is entitled Thunderbolt Gallop, and this piece falls under the category of a quick step march, commonly known as a circus march, which is officially what this piece was commissioned for. Marshes during live circuses was a very, very popular thing in America during the turn of the 20th century. There are no more live circuses like Barnum and Bailey's or any of those really famous circuses that traveled throughout the United States. Circus bands were oftentimes about a dozen or 16 members, and they played all the live music for an entire duration of a circus. So those musicians were excellent, excellent musicians, and there was a demand of each individual performer. Thunderbolt Gallop is an example of what you would hear at a circus. So we are very, very happy to bring Thunderbolt Gallop.
Thank you.
We have one final selection. Before we do so, I'll just do a couple of things that are out there. If you weren't at the Varsity Band concert or came in for this concert, we'll remind you that your sons and daughters at this time will be preparing chair placement auditions that will start taking place on Halloween for these kids. They should be signing up tomorrow to make sure that they have an appropriate time for those chair placements. We will also be getting auditions going here about the middle of November for jazz bands. So if your sons and daughters are interested in the jazz experience, that's going to be coming up. And we'll get our pep band stuff started in the class once we get to next week. And then those winter season games will start right before we leave for the winter break. So there's always a lot going on here in the band program, as you know. We will continue to try to communicate all those things to you best we can so that you're well informed what your sons and daughters should be doing. But we have one final selection for you. The kids really liked this piece. They really wanted it to be last night in concert. It does make a great closer. This is Table Rock Festival.
Thank you.
Good evening once again. Thank you so much for your patience tonight. We decided to catch that outstanding concert band performance, and that kind of took care of our warm-up at 7:30. But that's mostly the warm-up that we do every day anyway, so this will be as real as any fourth hour. We are the Symphonic Band. My name is Rich Berger. Super happy to have you in the audience tonight. It's really important for you to be here for our final test. And I know you're going to enjoy it. It's a really, really great band. It's been a joy to work with them this quarter. And we're just together for a couple more weeks. This is a group that's mixed of some members who will be in Symphonic Band fourth hour next year, and some members who will be in Wind Symphony third hour next quarter. But it's been really fun to work together, get to know each other a little bit, and we hope you enjoy what we have to offer tonight. Our first piece is called Seis Manuel. There's a number of local connections to it. I think it kind of, and hopefully you'll enjoy it more if you hear some of the details. Number one, the composer Shelley Hansen has a lot of local ties. She's an active musician in the Twin Cities area, played with the Minnesota Pops Orchestra, and also has written a lot of pieces that have been played all around the country, in Europe and Asia, all over the world, really. And this is one of those pieces. This piece was actually commissioned by the Minnesota Youth Symphonies, and the conductor of that group is Manny Loriano, who is also the principal trumpet player in the Minnesota Orchestra. But when he commissioned Shelley to write this piece of music, it was actually a four-movement work. This is a section of that larger work that's a Puerto Rican dance, and she named it after Manny because typically these Puerto Rican dances are named in honor of someone, and that's where we get the title, Seis Manuel.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Hope you enjoyed that. Some wonderful solo work and great ensemble playing as well. And super fun piece of music. Our next selection is written by Samuel Barber. Maybe not the most familiar American composer, but certainly an outstanding composer. I highly recommend you listen to some Samuel Barber. Some of his most famous works would include Adagio for Strings, or a couple of symphonies that are really wonderful, lots of chamber music, and lots of art music as well. This is actually written originally for soprano vocalist, and it's arranged really artfully by Richard Saucedo. Thank you. last piece is a collection of three movements, each based on some English folk songs and written by a really famous composer, Ray Vaughan Williams. It's a piece that is absolutely considered a band classic, a piece that we're really proud that the kids can graduate from Eastview knowing this piece and having played it, but we don't do it very often, and one of the reasons why is because there's not a lot of percussion parts. So in this quarter, with the opportunity of a small-ish percussion section where we can keep them busy and give them a taste of a new style of music, or a different style of music, I really wanted to take this opportunity to learn this. A couple of wonderful solos in the piece, a lot of variety, and some good English march music as well. Hope you enjoy all 3 minutes of English folk songs.
Thank you.
It has truly been our pleasure to play for you tonight. Thanks for coming. We have to clear the stage, and then I will release your students for the evening. Thank you very much. Good night.